This is the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.
And these are tonight's top stories. President Ronald Reagan and First Lady Nancy returned this week from an official visit to Canada. They were met at the airport by an overjoyed Vice President Bush, but Bush wasn't the only one happy to see the Reagans return. The Canadians were pretty thrilled about it, too. First Lady Nancy Reagan said this week that the press has been making her sound terrible and that they never give her a chance. Well, we here at the Friday edition would like to take exception to this statement. We have never made the First Lady look badly, and we will continue to present her in a favorable light. Two very famous people crossed paths this week, and to the dismay of many, it's the one on the right who is retiring. After spending $5 million and 7 years of research, a government commission has determined that the best way to shorten unemployment lines is to get everyone to stand much closer together. The theory of evolution as taught in schools was tested again in California in what is being termed the second Scopes trial. The verdict handed down was a virtual draw as Judge Irving Perlis decided that God had indeed created man, but he had gotten the idea from a monkey. Now, in the wake of a conservative tide that has been sweeping this country, one man has refused to move to the right. Now, a lot of people like Alan Alda, Phil Donahue, and Ed Asner have been very outspoken in their support of liberal causes, but one man, and only one, has had the guts to take a stand. Of course, I'm talking about the very, very liberal David Steinberg. David.
Or should I say Ms. Chartoff? And I was saying Ms. before it was fashionable, I might add. Before I begin with what I call the liberal challenge, I'd like to take a moment to prove to you, the audience, just exactly how liberal I really am. Here's a picture of me, I love this picture, getting right into a Mercedes. It's my Mercedes, just after I've come back from Watts, where I happen to be visiting a friend of mine. And this friend just happens to have been black. Here's a picture of me coming home late one night after I visited a friend of mine who just happens to have been a woman who just happens to have been raped. And here's a picture of me signing a check anonymously, of course, for a large sum of money to the gay pro-abortionists against nuclear dumping. I'm sure you're asking yourself, why am I telling you all this? Well, I'm here to tell you that in the midst of President Reagan's drastic cut in the social services, I feel that a challenge must be made to all the great liberals of Hollywood. I challenge Ed Asner, Phil Donahue, and Alan Alda to do what I'm about to do. This is rather touching. I'd like to call upon Maria Teresa something Spanish. Maria Teresa in the Spanish idiom. Maria, just come on out here. I don't like the Spanish language. Come on out. Hi, Maria. Are you hungry, dear? Hungry? Did they give you anything in the green room? No? Perhaps afterwards we'll have some quiche. Now, a lot of us can identify with this woman. And no one can identify with her more than I can. First of all, she is virtually penniless. She's been exposed to nuclear radiation. She's been forcibly pregnant over a dozen times without even a glimmer of orgasm. And someone, and we don't know who, recently shot her whale. Now, this is a coincidence. Maria just happens to be my cleaning lady. Now, the federal government has cut back on provisions to aid this woman. And that is why, on live national TV, I am challenging all those great Hollywood liberals. I'm challenging Asner, Donahue, Alda, and all the others out there to come up with something that is close to what I am about to do. If this catches on, it might even be more popular than the fad of adopting Vietnamese orphans a few years back. I've told Maria that I am going to marry her.
Thank you, Mr. Stevenson.
And back to you, Melanie.
David, my heartiest congratulations, and the same to you, Mrs. Steenieberg. or something. Lastly, and I mean lastly, after 33 weeks as your anchor woman here at the Friday Edition, I have decided to step down so that I can go on to do more sketches on Fridays and do other things elsewhere. Now, I don't want to make a big thing out of this or anything. This is just merely a transition. A passing of a baton to a great broadcaster, woman, and friend of mine, Maryedith Burrell. Maryedith. And that's the way it is, Friday, March 13th, 1981. I'll be away on assignment, and Maryedith Burrell will be sitting in here for the next few years. Thank you, and good night. Your warmth and your overwhelming response to my departure that I've had second thoughts. I've decided I'm not going to retire. I can't do it. So I want to thank you. I want to thank you, people. You're so very beautiful. Thank you. This is really incredible. So I guess it's really true. Old anchor women don't fade away. They just keep coming back for more. Thank you, and good night.
This has been the Friday Edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.